A quick tip for everyone on how to create a clipping mask inside Illustrator CC. A clipping mask is a shape called a clipping path that masks any object below it, so only what's inside of the clipping path is visible. A mask can take the shape of a rectangle, a circle, or any other vector shape, and any artwork can be masked. Now, a couple of things to know about clipping masks. The clipping path should always be on top of the object you would like to clip. And also, you can only have one clipping path, but more than one object can be clipped. So I'm going to show you how to create what you see on your screen and some more. First, I'm going to place a photo to be clipped inside a vector shape. So I'm going to the file menu. I'm going to use the place command. I'm going to select the picture I'm going to be using, this missed JPEG. Then click place. And then all you have to do is just click once to place the photo inside the artboard. All right, now for the vector shape, I'm going to create a circle. So for that, I'm going to click and hold here, and I'm going to select the ellipse tool, and I'm going to hold down the Alt Shift or Option Shift and draw a circle from the center, like so. Now, I want this circle to have a stroke, so I'm going to click on the stroke here, add a color to it, and then up in the control bar, I'm going to up the stroke weight, let's say, to 4 points. Now, I'm going to select those two objects because I want to center them first in relation to each other and then to the artboard. So for that, let's go up to the control bar here and make sure that you have the align to selection option. Then click on the horizontal align center and then the vertical align center, like so. And then to center all of these to the artboard, go back to the option here, select the align to artboard, then click on the horizontal align center and the vertical align center, like so. Okay, so now that we have both objects centered and selected, it's extremely easy to create a clipping mask. But again, I would like to refresh your memory that the vector shape should always sit on the top. In this case, it does sit on the top. And then the photo will be in the back. Okay, now, how to create a clipping mask? Go up to the object menu, clipping mask, and make. In this case, the shortcut is Control 7 or Command 7, like so. But you see, the problem here is that we lost a stroke. And of course, there is a way how to do it. One way will be to actually go to the layers panel here, open this up, and then open up the clip group, and then target the ellipse. But that's a long way to go. So I'm going to show you another way. So I'm going to undo this, Control Z or Command Z. I'm going to select just the photo, going to the edit menu. I'm going to cut this and put on the clipboard, then select the shape here, the circle. And then I'm going to turn on an option that is available at the very bottom of the toolbar. This is your toolbar. So at the very bottom here, I'm going to turn this option where it says Draw Inside. And as you can see, it says the shortcut is Shift D. So I'm going to press Shift D twice, Shift D and Shift D. And now I am inside the Draw Inside mode. So all you have to do is go up to the Edit menu and use the paste in place command to also retain position on the photo, like so. Now, as you notice here, I'm actually inside the edit contents, as you can see here in the control panel. And the edit contents is actually the photo. So I think the photo is too big. So I'm going to use Alt Shift, Option Shift, size this down, like so. And then if you wish to actually work on the vector shape, all you have to do is click what it says Edit Clipping Path. So click on that, And then let's say you want to maybe up the stroke weight a bit, like so. Okay. Once you're done, all you have to do is go back to the draw normal mode. And again, the shortcut will be Shift D, like so. Now, if you want to make this bigger, you can just hold down the Alt Shift or Option Shift and just size this up, like so. Another thing to consider is to actually add another object to be clipped inside the vector shape. In this case, I'm going to use the Type tool. I'm going to click once. I'm going to type Mist, like so. And then I'm going to hold down Alt Shift or Option Shift on the Mac to size this up. Let's say somewhere around here. And then I'm going to change its color. In this case, I'm going to go for white. And then all I have to do is just going to bring this down here. And actually, I want to clip this. So how do we do this? Well, the easiest way is to actually go inside the Layers panel, target this, which is the mist object, and bring this down below the ellipse, like so. And as you can see, this is already inside the clipping group. One more thing that you can do actually is to target the ellipse here, and you can add an effect. So let's do that. Let's go to the Effect menu. Under the Distort Transform, let's say I'm going to use the zigzag. I'm going to check on the preview, like so. Use smooth points, and maybe up the ridges per segment. Size it down a bit, and then click OK. See, that's another idea. Now, at the event that you want to toggle off the visibility of the effect, you can go to the Window menu, bring up the Appearance panel here, and then actually we need to target the ellipse, not the whole thing. So go up to the Window menu, Appearance, and as you can see here, we have the zigzag effect, and you can click to toggle on and off the visibility of the effect. Or if you don't want to, just click and drag this to the trace icon to delete it. Now, how about placing the photo inside text, the mist text, instead of the circle? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select everything here. I'm going to the Object menu, Clipping Mask, and then Release Everything. There we go. Now, do I need the circle? No. I'm going to delete that. I'm going to keep the mist here. I'm going to size this up a bit. Okay. Let's make sure that both of these again are aligned to each other, like so. And then let's do the same thing for the artboard. Okay. All right. Now, for this, white is okay, but also I would like to have a stroke. So let's bring up the stroke here. Let's create a different color, add a different color, not the same one. Let me up the stroke weight a bit. Maybe something like so, like a matching kind of color. Okay, now select the photograph. Again, go up to the Edit menu and then cut this, put it inside the clipboard. Select the mist type. Then you're going to go to the bottom of the toolbar. I'm going to go click on the Draw Inside mode here. Click on that and then go up to the Edit menu and then paste in place. And I will have the image inside the mist type. Now we're still on the edit contents here, so Alt Shift Option Shift to size this down a bit, like so. And if you wish to go and edit the clipping path, just click on that, and then maybe you can up the stroke weight and so on. Now click back to return to the draw normal mode, or use the shortcut Shift D. And so at the end, this is another idea how to create a clipping mask inside Illustrator CC using type. Clipping masks are fun to use and they can add some spice to your design. Just practice using different vector shapes and see what it takes you. This concludes this mini tutorial and thank you for watching.